Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we are going to be looking at Tynker. Now, Tynker is an educational programming platform that is really nicely integrated within Minecraft Education. So we're going to hit C on the keyboard here, and it will probably, the first time, take us to this screen here. So in the past, we've gone to Microsoft Make Code, and now we're going to go to Tynker here, which is does a lot of similar things. It does a few extra things as well, and it does them slightly differently. And it's got some really cool tutorials that certainly my students have really enjoyed working their way through, and they certainly have a lot of educational value. So, first of all, we're just going to power through these first four tutorials today really quickly. So at the end, we're going to get to see this make your own spleef game that you can play with your friends. We'll finish up with that one and the 1000 TNT. But very quickly, teleportation scroll. This is a nice one. So when you click that, it tells us, gives us an overview of what we're doing. We are going to drop a piece of paper, and we're going to teleport back to the beacon. So let's click next. And we're just dragging these in. Make sure your students read these. I've done these tutorials before, of course, so I'm going to kind of whiz through them. What's really nice is it says here what your code should look like. So Microsoft Make Code, it does talk you through the different steps, but it doesn't always show you exactly what they should look like. So that's pretty cool. I'm going to start a new line of code here. When the paper item is dropped, go to the Tinkerbot checkpoint named Recall, and then teleport the players to the Tinkerbot. So here, placing the beacon, setting a recall point, spawning the Tinkerbot, and when the paper's dropped, move the Tinkerbot back to the beacon and teleport the players to wherever the Tinkerbot is. So let's test it out. We're going to finish this tutorial, and we're going to click play down here, click the cross. There we go. Now, if I press E, I'm going to load up my inventory, and I need a beacon. So there's my beacon. Then I'm going to get my paper, because I want some paper. There we go. All right, so press Escape. I'm going to place my beacon there, which will spawn my Tinkerbot. And I'm going to just run over here a little bit, away from the beacon. There's the beacon. Use the mouse wheel to select my hotbar second infantry slot, and press Q to drop that piece of paper, and there I am, teleported back to the beacon. Okay, nice easy one. So, to move on to the next tutorial, actually very quickly what I could do is go back to the tutorial here. If it didn't work, you can actually click tutorial up there and go back through these steps, see what's going on. You can also then mess around with it a little bit if you want to change the beacon for a door, and you know, the paper for an apple, you can do it. Okay, but for now, we're going to click the house in the top left here. We don't want to save these changes because this is a tutorial that's already saved in the tutorial section, so no need to save that in our projects. Then, next one, Path of Petals. Let's get through this one pretty quickly. So, we're going to create a mod that leaves a path of flowers behind you as you walk. Beautiful. So, when player travels, if travel type is walking, then it should look like this. Can we drag that in? No. And then we're going to set block red flower at, this is where it's important that we read this text here, because it says 000 here. So we need to set that to 000. Click next. We need to finish this tutorial. We can set it to sprinting if we like, but we're not going to. We're going to test it out on walking. Click play. Click cross. Let's go out into our kind of third person mode. And there are our flowers, leaving a lovely trail behind us as we go. Right, back into first person, and let's have a look at the next tutorial. So, house in the top left, no changes to be saved here. 1000 TNT, instantly generates a massive block of 1000 TNT. Says it all, doesn't it there? Okay, so this will register an event when you type 1000 TNT in the chat. So we're gonna drag these across. Encourage your students to look at what they do, the different colors, different categories, and so on. So when we open up the message chat, it's going to check for what the message is. If it's 1000 TNT, then this is going to happen. We're going to fill from 11111 to 10101010 with TNT. Next. Try your mod. Let's test it out. Okay, done. Play and cross. And we want to press T to load up our chat. Click in the box and type 1000 TNT, lowercase, enter. And there's our TNT. Now, just to, you know, you can't leave this here and not explode it, can you? So let's chuck some red. Let's chuck a redstone block on top and blow this thing up. There we go. It's going to cause problems. Wow. Yeah, this is going to cause some issues in my world. All right, okay, interesting. So, yeah, that's done some damage. So, yeah, that's quite a cool mod. Obviously, your students will really enjoy that one. Click the house in the top left. No changes before saving, thank you. And the last one, Bleef. It's a Bleef game that you can play with your friends. So, let's go ahead and see what this does. It's a Bleef game. Players destroy blocks below. The other players cause them to fall into the pit. So it creates a multiplayer game where you're trying to knock the other person into the lava. So on start, move Tinkerbot to player. Move the Tinkerbot up by 20 blocks, and it should look like this, which it does. Then, oh yeah, you can scroll up and down in these, by the way. So it doesn't show all the information necessarily. You do have to scroll down. Keep an eye on this sidebar. So then we're going to build a filled box using bedrock, which is interesting because I think then the next bit of coding is to hollow it out, but I trust them. We're going to do it efficiently. Move Tinkerbot forward by one block and then build a filled box using air. So I don't know why we couldn't just use a hollow box, but I think they want one side of it to be open. I think that's why. Then check that it looks like this. It does. And then we go to air. We have to scroll up and down in this a lot. So when we click next, it doesn't scroll back up for us. So don't miss any lines of code by not scrolling back up. Then we're going to build another filled box with lava that's going to sit at the bottom of the first box that we built out of bedrock. We're going to move the Tinkerbot up by 8 blocks above the lava and fill another layer, so height 1, so it's one layer, of snow. Next. So scroll up again, then move Tinkerbot up by 1 block, so now it's above the snow. Teleport the players on top of the snow. Set the game mode to survival. Let's just move this whole thing up a little bit. And then give a diamond shovel to all the players. And it should look like this. I mean, that's so small you can't really tell. But yeah, I think it looks like that. So let's click next. Let's click done. I think you do need to click done to get these working properly sometimes. Okay, so click the cross. Now, oh, hello. Oh, it set me into, okay, respawn. Let's do game mode. Creative at A, so I don't instantly die. Let's go and get my diamond shovel back. Where is my diamond shovel? Okay, it doesn't matter. Right, so here's what this game looks like. This is the Bleef game, I guess. So we've got the lava underneath. You put two players up here, and then you take it in turns to run around and destroy all the blocks of snow until one person falls in. You don't need a diamond shovel to do it. You can just, well, I guess if you were in creative mode, you don't need a diamond shovel, but then you could fly, so that would be cheating. So yeah, we need the diamond shovel. And then you take it in turns to knock away the blocks until you fall down, and we have a winner. So I guess the students might quite like that. You'd need to explain to them what a Bleef game was, maybe. I don't know if students would know stuff like that. I'm going to test it out with mine this week. And yeah, then we can press C, we can go back through our code, we can make the boxes different sizes, we can replace the snow with different stuff, we can replace the diamond shovel and so on. And we could replace the on start with something else,